Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this channel, we are going to discuss about chemistry and biology concepts regarding SSLC and PUC. Okay, in this video, today we are going to discuss about SSLC chemistry MCQ questions. Okay, fine. So let's start with the first question. Complete the given reaction from the following. So this question is asked from acid, bases and salts lesson. So here we can see that the question is 2NaOH plus Zn is going to form dash plus H2. So this kind of questions will be definitely asked in this 2021 board examination. It can be asked. Okay, fine. So now we have to find out what is the product formed here. Okay, so they have given the options like 2NaZnO, Na2ZnO2, Na2ZnO and NaZnO2. So how we can easily find out the answer? That is the main thing. Okay, so let us see how to do it. One easy method I will tell you, it is balancing. From the given options to the given question, just try to figure the balancing equations, then definitely it will be easier for us to find out the answer. So let us check with the first option. It is 2NaZnO. So we can see that how many molecules of sodium is there? Na. Yes, here Na is there. And what about O? O is also having two molecules. And H is already have liberated the gas. So here we need not to worry about H2 or H, hydrogen. Okay, so now and zinc. So it is not going to balance because oxygen is imbalanced here. Fine, let's try with the second option. Second option, it is going to show that sodium Na2. So here also two molecules are there. And zinc, it is having only one molecule. And zinc, they have given one as it is. And again here, O2 is there. And we can see that the molecules are going to be balanced. So, in this way, we have to find out the exact options by using the other chemistry concepts. So, for this question, if you try to balance the equation, then definitely you will get the answer. And what is the compound name? This is known as sodium zincate. Okay. And you can also refer the textbook. This question is given in page number 20, chemistry. Part 1 textbook. Okay, fine. Let's move on to the next question. Which of the following can be used as an acid-base indicator by a visually impaired student? So, in this question, we have to focus on the basic word visually impaired student. So, visually impaired means a person who is not having a proper vision. Okay, so we all know that we are going to use the indicator to check the color of the solution and to neutralize the solution. Yeah, so on. But here what happens, visually impaired means the person cannot see the change what is going to happen. Okay, so at that time, what kind of indicator we can use? That thing we have to think at the first point. So here they have given the options, litmus, turmeric, vanilla essence and China rose. So I think something sounds fishy here, we can easily choose vanilla essence. We all know that vanilla essence is an indicator called as olfactory indicator, which is going to be detected based on the smell. So visually impaired people can recognize the smell of the vanilla essence. So option C is the correct answer. Okay, so let's go for the third question. It is choose the incorrect statement. From the given sentence, electrovalent compounds are dash. So in this question, what we have to do, we have to find out the incorrect statement, which is not relevant to this statement, we have to choose it. Okay, so let us see what are the options are given. Option A, it is insoluble in kerosene. Option B, it's going to conduct electricity. Option C, share the electrons. Option D, they are having high melting and boiling points. Okay. First, we have to understand what is this electrovalent compounds. We know that electrovalent compounds are also called as ionic compounds. It is also known as ionic compounds. So, what are ionic compounds? Ionic compounds are the one which is going to produce the charge among the particles. So, Electrovalent compounds are also the one which is insoluble in kerosene. Okay, we know that it is soluble only in the solvents like water. It is insoluble in kerosene and petrol. And also, electrovalent compounds are good conductor of electricity because they are having the ions with them. The positive and the negative ions will be there. And when we come to the share the electrons, the ionic compounds do not share the electrons. They are going to donate and accept the electrons from the molecules. And the fourth option is they are having high melting and boiling points. So when we compare all the options, we can conclude that sharing of electrons is not possible in case of electrovalent compounds or ionic compounds. So the correct answer is option C. The fourth question, a functional group mainly determines dash. So functional group, this is from the chapter carbon and its compounds. So this is also one of the important chapter. It is in part 2 textbook of SSLC. Fine. So functional group is the one which is mainly attached with the carbon compounds based on what properties they have asked. The question is based on what? Based on physical property, chemical property, both, none of this. So physical property means it depends on the how many carbon compounds are there, what is the structure, is it the branched or a skeletal structure. We are going to decide based on that. So we know that functional group cannot be decided based on the physical properties, or we can't decide it by the temperature and all. So second option is chemical properties. So here we have to think little bit. So what is this chemical properties? Chemical properties in the sense, along with the carbon compound, if any functional groups has been attached to the carbon compound, then we can call it as a chemical properties. And option C, it is asked both. So it is going to depend based on the physical property of the compound also and based on the chemical properties of the compound also. And option D is none of this. So option D is going to say that not even anything, some other property is there to choose the functional group. So what is the correct answer? So let me take an example of propanol. Okay. So it is a single bond compound. Okay. So functional group we are talking about. So if I just add here OH, then this is going to represent the presence of alcohol in the carbon chain. So what will be the name of this compound? It will be propanol. So this is the thing which is going to determine the functional group. So the functional group is going to be determined mainly based on the chemical properties. So the correct answer is option B. Fifth question. 101 element is dash. Means what is that element? Which is that element? We have to find out. So the given options are Rutherfordium, Americium, Mendelevium and Nobelium. So it is quite confusing for you, right? So it's very simple. In the periodic classification, we have already discussed so many times that Mendeleev is the person who have given the contribution for the periodic table, and we got to know how the elements have been arranged. So he have given a great idea to construct a modern periodic table. So keeping that in the mind, they have just to give a tribute for Mendel, it's just decided to keep 101 element as Mendelevium. So to contribute, to give a contribution for his work, this great thing has been decided. So Mendelevium is the correct answer. MD is the symbol of that element and atomic number of that compound is 101. So here the correct option is option C. So children, here we will be coming again by extra more questions. So these are the top 5 questions which I have chosen from the syllabus that may be expected to be asked in the board examination. Thank you. Keep watching, like it and subscribe my video.